Now they go the tight end, unbalanced. Up the middle, they run, flag on the play. That could be holding. He got the first down. The flag is in the middle where you usually see holding. Check the call. He needed a fourth of a yard for a first down. There's a flag on the 29. I think it's holding. Riverdale, Bill Melton's the referee. He called holding Riverdale. That will take him back to the 19. Big break, Ledman. He had picked up the first down. They had handed that football right straight up the middle. Got the first down. They'll penalize him back to the 19 and a half. Oh, actually, put it on the 20, only penalized them 9 yards. So what we're looking at now is second down, and they have to go to the 30-yard line, and they're on the 20. The flag was lying on the 19. We only got a 9-yard penalty out of that. Pro set. Split in left. Back to pass. Draw. Fake the draw. Looking down the middle. Got a man open. Throw. Caught. Flag on the play. Caught up on the 36. There's a flag on this play. It's a first down. The pass was completed down on the 36-yard line. Davis just simply drilled that ball in there to number 81, Peebles. First down. Check the flag. Now, 7:22 and a quarter. Another flag. Who's it against? Offensive pass interference, Riverdale. Or is that an illegal receiver downfield? One or the other. Tommy, what do you got?
That's loss of down anyway, Bruce. The signal behind the head from Bill Melton. Like loss of down on that penalty. Offensive pass interference. Apparently, Riverdale running some kind of pick play.
Gary Rankin. Gary Rankin has gone crazy on the sideline. He went crazy 2 years ago over here on the sideline.
You know, they're still talking about that punt they thought they ran back for a touchdown 2 years ago.
Davis, tremendous arm, as you can see on that, Tommy. Drilled it right in there to Peebles on the 36.
Absolutely. Hit Peebles right between the 8 and the 1 on the curl, right in the middle of that secondary. And he was in great shape. Play action, fake, kind of held the linebackers. And he found Peebles open over the middle. Now it's third down and long.
Third and 20. Ball is all the way back to the 10. They got to go to the 30. They got a slot left, and now the unbalanced line. Unbalanced line left. Take it. Run a option. Give it to the man up the middle. He exploded all the way to the 32. So the Edison runners up the middle. They go all the way to the 32, carrying the football, Fletcher. Fletcher raced for 22 yards. Maybe 23 and got to the 33, picked up 23 yards on a straight dive.
Last week against Glencliff, Fletcher only ran the football 6 times. He had 115 yards from scrimmage for the Warriors.
He got 23 on that one and a first down. A couple of penalties that hurt Riverdale, but not enough to keep them from first down. They come out in a smokestack eye and then they shift to an unbalanced line, I think. And they're going to run a sweep to this side, and they cut it in, and we come up and miss him, and then we miss him again, and we knock him down on the 39, and he got about 6 out of it. Running the ball that time was Johnson, and he got to the 39 and got 6, and it's second down and 4. Riverdale and Lebanon, no score, first quarter, 6:03 to play. This possibly could be the battle for the championship. Down the road. Riverdale has got a wide slot left with a tight end now shifting of the unbalanced line again. They're going unbalanced and they run that dive and we hit him and we knock him down on the 41 and he's about 3 yards short. He's got to go to the 44 or 43. He's about 2 yards short. Tommy, they're going unbalanced with us. They got a couple of wide outs and a tight end of that side, unbalanced left most of the time.
And thinking back, that is basically the same look Mount Juliet gave us in the first half last week that caused us some problems. They had a tight end on one side, 2 flankers on that same side, and Riverdale obviously has done their homework. They're trying to do the same thing that Mount Juliet did.
And they come out in the same set, unbalanced left. Take the ball. Davis runs a trap. We hit him. We knock him down. He didn't get it. I think it was Tony Cantrell down under, also 45. That would be Marlo C., our stunting linebacker, knocked him down on the 41. He didn't gain anything. Riverdale's got a punt.
Great job by that defense, Bruce, as they tried to come with a little counteraction, and we just knock him down. Not much going at all on the play. Back to punt for Riverdale is Davis.
Davis stands on the 28. Damon Stone stands on the 22. No wind, I don't think. The flag says no wind. The punt's away, a good one. High in the air, Damon will let it hit, and it almost hit us. And a flag went down or something. Let's see what we got. Riverdale wants the ball. I don't think they're going to get it. They're going to spot it on the 27. Some kind of marker come flying through the air, I think just for the spot. They'll spot the ball on the 27. Lebanon will take over. Riverdale thought Lebanon had touched it.
32 yards on that punt as Davis, double duty, quarterback and punter for Riverdale. If you think back a year ago, folks, he got off about a 70-yard punt on a quick kick last year.
Ball is on the 27. We're in a slot left. Triplett takes the ball and gives it to Rose. No, he don't. Gives it to Maneer. He got a yard, and then we got a flag. That could be face mask. Or it could be holding. We've got another flag, so there's a lot of flags already early in this ball game. Lebanon's got a man down. It's Zach Maneer.
Bruce, it looks like it was a face mask. They jerked Maneer's head around, so it looks like it is going to be a face mask.
I think that will be 15, won't it, John?
More than likely, because it looked like it was flagrant.
All right, 15-yard penalty, Riverdale. Riverdale right now probably thinking they're getting some home cooking.
Bruce, Zach was late getting up off the ground. It looked like he took a finger in the eye because he was really rolling around down there and had some obvious problems with that eye. John, you might check him out.
That penalty will come all the way from the 28 to the 43, give Lebanon a first down on the 43, 15-yard face mask penalty. First down Lebanon on the 43, their own 43, 338. First quarter, no score, Lebanon Riverdale. Slot left, Triplett takes it, sweep. Outside, Neal got hit, lost a couple, back to the 41. We tried to run a sweep. The sophomore Neal got knocked down and lost two on the 41. We're second and 12.
John, what about Zach?
He got a finger in the eye, Tom, and I think he's going to go over and pour water in it. But it's definitely red. He caught a finger right in the eye.
Ball on the 41. And 3 minutes to go in the first quarter. Lebanon 0, Riverdale 0. We come out in a pro set this time. Split in left, flanker right, back to pass. Looking, screen, won't work. Triplett falls back down on the 431 and lost 9 or 10. He lost 10. Triplett was looking, I think, for a screen in the middle. Then he got pushed out of the pocket, and they knocked him down. Actually, he fell down back on the 31.
Checking in with the play is Mo Thompson. Out comes Damon Stone for Lebanon. We have zone Stone and Maneer going double duty, playing both sides of the football, and they do alternate in, so it's not like they're going completely both ways.
This time we go with a pro left. Back to pass, Triplett. We run the draw. Neal's got a little daylight. 35 and got hit hard on a 39 and got knocked down. Picked up about 7 or 8 yards. Tyson Neal, the sophomore tailback, got to the 39. We've got the punt. No score. Going back deep, Tommy, who we got? 24. That would be who?
Back deep in punt return formation for Riverdale is Alvin Duke, just a sophomore. Good speed on Duke.
Skullruber punt from the 30. It's a punt, pretty good punt. Not too high, but it'll hit on the 28 and roll, and they'll pick it up, and we'll hit him and miss him. And he got to the 30, and he got to the 40, and we great. Maybe a touchdown-saving tackle by number 2 of the Blue Devils. That would be Bo Grissom. I think he just saved a long touchdown run.
And Bruce, 8 yards on that return, just 27 on the punt, and it looked like Riverdale's going to go with this no-huddle offense. They're getting their hand signals, trying to get the play in. Bo made a great block on the punt attempt, and now he made the tackle.
No-huddle, they're trying to get a man off the play, return it 12 or 14 yards. They run Johnson up the middle. He got to the 45 and got three. It's second and seven. So they're going with no-huddle, but they were a little delay of getting people into the game. Riverdale has used this no-huddle offense, kind of like you see on pro football, the Cincinnati Bengals. They just line up and run it and get their plays from the bench. 81 is running in, 86 is running out, 40 seconds in the quarter, no score. Second down and seven, back to pass, Staten's looking, quick screen, almost intercepted. It should have been a fumble, I think. That should have been, I think. If I'm not mistaken, Tony Cantrell could have run back and picked that football up, because that pass, Tommy, was definitely thrown behind him. That would almost been called a fumble.
If not behind him, definitely to the side, a lateral, and Tony breaking through and knocked the thing loose. For all accounts, it very well could have been a live football.
They call it an incomplete pass. It's third and seven, a ball on a 45. Back to pass, David. Here comes a rush. We missed him. He got out of there. He's running to the 45. He shows his great athletic ability and got to the 50. Well, we are really putting some pressure on him. But again, I look back at the previous play, and I still think that was a lateral, and Tony Kensler could have picked that football up, Tommy, and raced it in the end zone. That run by Davis got to the 49. They are about 3 yards short, and there's 20 seconds to go in the first quarter. There's no score.
Donnie, back at the station, will be taking a 30-second break after the end of the first quarter.
Ball on the 49, Riverdale's own 49. 20 seconds to play. He ran out of bounds in the first quarter. Davis will punt. Back deep, DeMond Stone stands on the 21. Snap is back. Punt is away. Line drive punt. DeMond could return this, but he caught it on the 20, laying on the ground. So we'll take over on the 20, 13 seconds to play. In the